knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
In the previous tutorial, we began examining phylum Chordata, which contains organisms that possess these five chordate characteristics at least some point in their lives. And as we learned, within the phylum Chordata, there are three extant subphyla: Cephalochordata, the lancelets; Tunicata, the tunicates; and Vertebrata, the vertebrates. With the lancelets covered, let's now check out the tunicates. Once again, the sister clade to the cephalochordates are the olfactories, which are further split into subphylum Tunicata, sometimes called Urochordata, and its sister group, subphylum Vertebrata, also called Craniata. Subphylum Tunicata is quite a bit more diverse than Cephalochordata, with over 3,000 marine species found in the oceans worldwide. They include a wide range of colorful, translucent, and nearly transparent species. Though some species are solitary as adults, others replicate by budding and can become colonial superorganisms comprised of identical individuals. As adults, most tunicates, especially the sea squirts, are sessile filter feeders, but they metamorphosize from free-swimming larval forms. Though they may not look like it, they are the sister group to all vertebrates. In order to study these organisms, let's go over their anatomy and physiology, life cycle, classification, and relationship to the vertebrates. The body of a tunicate is enclosed in a thick, rubbery outer covering called a tunic, which gives them their common name. The tunic is composed of a carbohydrate called cellulose, which provides support and protection for the animal. Tunicates can range in size from just a few millimeters to more than a meter in length, depending on the species. They are filter feeders that primarily feed on plankton and other small particles in the water. Tunicates have an incurrent siphon through which they filter food and an excurrent siphon through which they expel waste. Their digestive system begins when water that enters through the incurrent siphon passes through the cilia-lined pharynx and pharyngeal basket, which contains the pharyngeal slits and endostyle that trap food and transport it to the stomach. Their circulatory system consists of a ventral heart and two large vessels that branch into the pharyngeal basket that also functions in gas exchange as well as digestion. Their nervous system is comprised of a simple nerve ganglion and nerve groups, and most sensory organs are absent in adults. Juveniles, however, have a notochord, eye spots, and statocyst. Tunicates are well known for their unique life cycles. Many species are capable of sexual and asexual reproduction. Tunicate asexual reproduction is generally accomplished through budding, and sexual reproduction is generally external and indirect through the release of gametes in the water column. A fertilized egg develops into a free-swimming tadpole larva that undergoes rapid metamorphosis into an adult. First, the free-swimming larvae attach to the substrate using the anterior adhesive papillae. They begin to absorb their tail within the first 5 minutes of attachment, followed by the rotation of the organs, and then siphon until they attain the adult position. This generally happens in less than 18 hours. Metamorphosis then continues with the enlargement of the pharynx and the loss of the outer layer of the cuticle. From start to finish, the entire process generally takes about 48 hours. Though the typical adult tunicate only has two of the five chordate characteristics, their tadpole larval form does demonstrate all five. Traditionally, the tunicates were split into three classes: appendicularia, thaliacea, and acidiacea. However, more recent analyses suggest that acidiacea is actually an artificial paraphyletic group of more distantly related tunicates. The vast majority of tunicates, over 2,300 species in fact, are grouped within Acidiacea. They are collectively known as sea squirts because some species forcefully discharge a jet of water from their excurrent siphon as a defense mechanism. They are characterized by their tough outer tunic made of polysaccharides, and they may be solitary or colonial. Members of class Appendicularia, commonly referred to as larvacea, resemble juvenile tunicates even as sexually mature adults. Some species, like the giant larvacean, produce mucus houses that they use to filter water as they swim in the water column. Finally, members of class Thaliacea are free-floating for their entire lives, with complex life cycles, as well as both solitary and colonial forms. They are split into three orders. First, there is Salpida, also called salps, which includes the planktonic tunicates that move through jet propulsion and are often colonial. Second, there is Pyrosomida, also called pyrosomes, which can form colonial superorganisms. Finally, there are the minuscule members of order Doliolida. Despite their apparent differences from vertebrates, recent molecular studies have confirmed that tunicates and vertebrates are part of the same clade, which is called olfactories. This suggests that tunicates and vertebrates share a common ancestor and evolved from a similar body plan. While the exact relationship between tunicates and vertebrates is still under debate, recent evidence suggests that tunicates are more closely related to vertebrates than previously thought. The similarities between tunicates and vertebrates, such as the presence of a notochord, dorsal nerve cord, and pharyngeal slits, suggest that these structures were present in their common ancestor and have been modified and adapted over time in different lineages. And with that, we've covered all of the invertebrate chordates, but we're still just getting started with the phylum Chordata.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.